You're good.
Good.
That's right there. Yeah, they buried a sewer line in here about 3 years ago. They topped it with clay soil so it doesn't drain off. It just sort of soaks or just stagnates. I'll have algae on it before
it evaporates. So long as it doesn't stink, I don't know.
Yeah. No, they did that. We told them, they said, when they told us what they did, I'm like, really, clay soil?
Clay, huh?
Where the hell did you go to get that? East side of the state?
Yeah. Yeah, they don't have clay around here naturally, right?
Is this yours?
Yeah.
Oh, that's...
Back up, I film all my backs. And this is a 360 camera, and see, it's a full circle.
Really?
So I don't have to set up two cameras anymore to catch. People said, I didn't see the other part you did. I was like, well, I bought this one.
Yeah.
And it sees all the way. The viewer can use their mouse or the goggles.
Yeah.
You know, those VR goggles.
Yeah.
Or they could just use their finger with the arrows.
Okay.
And turn the whole screen around and watch.
Oh, that's cool.
Like this. It looks up, down, all around.
That'd be very cool.
Yeah, it's pretty cool.
Helps you. What do you see? You backed up on the trail on the dock.
Yeah. Okay, somebody says... Not you guys, but somebody might say, hey, you hit my truck, or you hit this, you broke that. I go, show me on the video exactly where I hit it again. Oh, never mind, driver, you're good. Right? It does never happen, but
right.
Cover your butt.
Just cover your ass.
Right.
I learned that a long time ago.
Yes, sir.
We'll get you started. I've already got one bale on the truck.
What do we got, a cardboard or can?
Cardboard.
Oh, okay. Yeah, going to Toledo, of course.
Going to Toledo. All right?
All right, bud.
I'll let you know when I'm done, unless you're going to hang out outside.
I'll be here.
I tell a lot of drivers, if you guys are tired of sitting down, there's a bike path right there.
Really?
It goes 10 miles out.
Ooh. Well, you think it'll be that long?
That shouldn't be that long.
See, I got to be careful with this because it looks like a gun.
Right?
You get the cops, you know how people go up to the cops and say, what's your badge and number? What's your name? And they might shoot you for this.
Right? They very well could. We just had a officer-involved shooting about a month and a half ago down. Yeah, the guy was, for whatever reason, decided he was going to charge a cop with a, what do you have?
Suicide by cop, maybe, some
he
of these people.
He had something in his hand. What the hell, was it a tire iron? We had another guy charge a cop with a machete. She put him down with a taser. This guy came at her, and they said she fired three times. Two of them hit him, one of them missed and got a bystander, which grazed the leg, but...
Still, people getting hurt.
It was a female cop going up against a fairly good sized guy.
Well, you got to figure, you know, you train for that, but then when it actually the real world hits you, it's very nervous time.
I talk to people all the time. I used to be when I was in college, I was a biology major. Mm. I was looking to chase grizzlies for the rest of my life.
Ah,
I'm in a whole different world now. It's a hell of a lot safer in here.
Yeah, grizzlies.
Bears are a hell of a lot safer. But I was talking to somebody, they said, well, I don't carry pepper spray, I carry a gun. I said, okay, let me put it this way. How trained are you on it? I practice all the time. Okay. You practice all the time. Are you practicing at hitting a target that's about that big, that's moving all over the place as it's running directly at you?
And the bullets will bounce off.
And you got that adrenaline dump into your system. Are you sure you can hit that target?
Yeah.
Well, yeah, I'm pretty sure I could. Well, pretty sure
you always hear the stories of the Old West. The bears didn't stop, you know, when they...
Right.
Especially while you had to go 1 minute per round, you know.
Right.
But you got to hit him in the soft spot, like an eyeball or something.
There's a guy up here. I bought my ammo for my. I carry a 40 Smith & Wesson, which for grizzlies you should technically have a 10, which is the same caliber but more powder on it.
Oh yeah.
But this guy, he makes a. What does he call it? Cold cast, solid. That he makes for mm-hmm. barrel loads. He makes them in 45. He makes them in 10, and he makes them in 40. And I thought, that might be a decent bear repellent round.
Yeah.
I carry both. I carry a pistol with me when I'm hiking, as well as my pepper spray, because the pepper spray puts out, it's like a shotgun spray. But on a windy day, it's useless.
Ah, yeah, true.
You just likely to catch a face full of stuff as a bear.
It might come back at you.
There was a story, a guy was elk hunting up here north of town, bow hunting, and he says he got this really thick brush. And he says he could hear something moving towards him. And after a while, he's like, that doesn't sound like an elk moving. That sounds something more serious.
Yeah.
So he said he set his bow to the side, pulled his pepper spray out, removed the safety on it, and he was aiming it at the general direction that it was coming in. When the bear stuck its head out, he he said I could have taken him, taken my arrow and tapped him on the nose with it. He was that close.
That close.
He says he gave the bear a blast. It was a windier day. He took a blast, but from that range, the bear got a full face full. And the guy got some spray back. He says the bear took off running down the hill right in the direction of his truck. And guy says, here I am on all fours, gagging and coughing and puking and trying to get the stuff out.
Totally defenseless.
And he says, and the bear, he says, I could hear the bear down about, he says, it sounded like 50, 60 yards down the hill doing the same thing I was.
Good thing, because he would have come back and, had a meal.
He says he got some water out, so he got his eyes rinsed out, and he says he was listening. There's the bear. He could still hear the bear coughing and sneezing, so he made a wide circle around. He says, I don't go back up on that hill anymore. I don't blame him. Bears are serious animals.
Yeah, we don't have any grizzlies left in California, even though it's a state flag animal. But I swear I saw some grizzlies up on Donner Pass last summer, last fall, whatever it was. They were bigger than a black bear. They look, I got a footage of them, but they're very grainy.
So in Colorado, the last grizzly was allegedly killed in around, I want to say it was in 78 or 79.
Mm.
Bow hunter. Officially killed by a hunter. Thought it was a black bear because they didn't have any grizzlies. This one showed up, he shot it, took it to the fishing games, and the fishing games said, it's a grizzly.
Grizzly! Yeah.
So, he didn't do anything illegal because they maintained that there were no grizzlies in the state. So, he got a flash forward several years. Another guy was bow hunting and was charged by a bear, and somebody wound up either the guide or he shot this bear, and they called fishing game. Fishing game says, whoops, another grizzly. We've been officially with no grizzlies, but they looked at the bear and it was a female who was less than the age for when they said that didn't have any more grizzlies in the state, so she was younger than that.
So obviously there's a breeding
and
population.
She had at least one set of cubs because they could tell by looking at the way her nipples looked that she
had first. She was a mother. Okay.
So there was at least two other bears in the state at that time, unless they got killed by something else. And I maintain there's probably a grizzly still. It's a big state. It's down in the interstate that goes across the highway that goes across the south end of the state from Cortez back to Pueblo. But it's down in the South San Juan Mountains.
50 maybe or something like that. 50?
I don't think it's an interstate. I think it's a highway.
Oh, I don't know. I haven't been to Colorado in a long time. I did see a moose in Colorado one time on, I think it was 50. It was like this switchback mountain road.
Yep.
I was like, oh my God, there's a high step of moose. That's cool. That's why I started carrying cameras, because you never know the stuff you see. There's bighorn sheep over here. I saw a pheasant and a turkey yesterday, too.
When I came out here, I had a pheasant over here. It was a male that was standing up on those mounds out there.
Right here?
Yeah. And they'll start falling. I heard him just as I came out. Usually I can see him. They'll stand on top of these mounds, these dirt mounds. And they'll make their noise and they'll look for a female out there.
Oh, yeah.
Well, I'll go ahead and get started on
it. All right, bud, appreciate it.
Shouldn't take any more.
Okay, well, I won't go too far then. Let me turn my key off. Sucking down batteries. The truck turns itself off after 5 minutes. But it's not good to leave that key on. I mean, it's just... Everything in the truck is running, so... There we go. Watch this guy. See if he hooks up another can or is he dropping them all off? I think he's just leaving. They're loading a bunch of cans. Let's go over here and see what he said. There was a hiking trail. I actually kind of want to film this. This is interesting to me. I know forklift videos are not very popular on my channel. I have a whole playlist of forklifts, which, don't seem to be very, very, very popular. Let me put you guys over here, maybe. I can't reach up that high. Maybe right here. Should be good enough. There you go. There you go.
so all we got to do is get a new clamp. I think they're about $50 more or less. No big deal. I'm more concerned about the $500 camera, which seems to be still working. Tough little camera. But I will, let me think. I got a some accessories. Let me think here for a minute. I still have some accessories for the other GoPro. The mount on this one is identical to the other two GoPros, which I have hardware for, which we can still like clamp it to things and stuff like that. So, but that clamp, that clamp I was using is my go-to clamp that I've been using for a long time. But what are you gonna do? How much battery's left? 23, we're, two more bales, he said. I should have clamped it to the forklift itself. I used to unload my own loads, flatbedding, and I would clamp it somewhere all over the forklift to make different videos. Skytrack, get it. I use the Skytrack.
Oh yeah.
Uno mais. The trailer went from above the dock to below the dock. I wanted to show them that too. You see that? That's a heavy, heavy load. It'll come back up when I air up the airbags on the trailer.
We're probably going to be, we're all the way back, right?
All the way back right now, yeah. Want to slide them forward a little bit?
I typically tell drivers 8 to 10 holes back is a good place to start.
And then we'll check on the weights.
They've been averaging a shade over 2,000 a piece. I put 21 on. So
42 rather. It should be fine.
I don't know why, but paper weighs more than this stuff does.
As long as it's not wet.
Right.
All
right,
I'll be right. Let me go.
I'll meet you up at the front. Stop where, if you want to do the steers, and then do the whole tractor. I can do the math and figure what's on the drives, on the adding machine, and then the
trailer. Can we go this way, or do I have to turn around? Or do you go this way?
This morning, he did not.
You can get out this way?
You can go out this way. There's a mud puddle on the left as you go past her. You don't want to swing right, swing wide around that corner, around the far end of the building.
So what do you recommend?
I recommend going this way.
Oh, okay.
Just because I don't know how soft that stuff is
out
there. Otherwise, I'd tell you try a U-turn right there, but then they blocked it with this bin sticking out further.
Yeah.
I would go around that way, and then you can either do what the driver did yesterday, which was he pulled out and then backed up along the scale and then came up onto the scale from this direction.
Or you, that's a good idea.
Had one this morning, he went.
Well, when I backed out into the gate and then came on it, that's kind of, is that all right?
The one this morning did it that way. He came in between the building and the scale, backed out the gate, and then back up, and then he went all the way around to when he left. That way worked too. This was, you know, believe it or not, a week ago, this was all bone dry out here. We had no snow up here this year.
Did you have a snowstorm or something?
We've had two.
In April?
Saturday and Sunday was just a downpour. Yesterday, it came down pretty good yesterday, too.
So, oh, rain. Yeah, I heard it was raining up here.
Saturday, I thought, what am I in Florida? There was so much, there was so much snow, rain coming down. I thought you were back in Florida.
Oh yeah, Florida, hot, humid, nasty.
Bugs everywhere.
Oh man. Can't keep the truck clean with the bugs.
Cockroach the size of your hand. Took the kids down to Disney World that one time, and I swear to God, that cockroach is about as big as the wall in my hand.
Oh man, tropical.
And it was like climbing up the wall right inside the hotel room, and I'm like, nope, I want to go somewhere else. We got mosquitoes, but that's about as bad as it gets up here.
Yeah.
Black widows every now and then, but that's okay. All right, well, I'll meet
beautiful
you
country. All right, Bob, I'll be there. Yeah, unfortunately, I lost my little clamp. That was a very, very versatile clamp. I used it all the time on everything. All right, party peeps, so let's end it right here. We're just gonna go weigh the load, get our paperwork, and that'll be it. All right, talk soon.